The Illuminati Formula to Create an Undetectable Total Mind Control Slave by Fritz Springmeier and Cisco Wheeler. Podcast 1. Dedication. This book is dedicated to the 2 million Americans and counting who have been programmed with monarch-type trauma-based mind control. This book is written to destroy trauma-based mind control before it destroys the human race. It's time for this horrendous secret to end. It is also written as part of God's end-time work to propel people of faith to the high calling that is prophesied of the body, but cannot be attained without men of faith understanding these things. Humanity's great prophet said he came to heal those whose hearts had been broken, literally split and crushed, and to free those who are captive. That work needs to go forward. Blood, sweat, and tears are associated with this book. The blood of the innocent victims of this mind control cries out in a single unison, along with the pungent sweat of those who have tried to minister help to the shattered humanity left by the sadistic programmers, and the pools of tears shed as this book was written. How long, O Lord, holy and true, do you not judge and avenge our blood on earth? Warning, read this first before reading the book. If there is any chance you the reader have had mind control done to you, you must consider the following book to be dangerous. If you are consulting a therapist for DID, also known as MPD, it is recommended that you consult your therapist before reading this book. The complications that could result for those under mind control learning the truth could be fatal. The co-authors take no responsibility for those who read or misuse this information. The reader's mind is like a garden. It may not be time to plant the truth in your mind. Perhaps you need some weeding or ground preparation, before the garden of your mind is ready. Perhaps the weather is too stormy to plant the truth. Pray to the Lord of the harvest. The blessings that flow from planting the information of this book in your mind will require the presence of living waters of love. If you do not have love in your heart, this book is not for you. The information contained in this book is the biggest news story of the 20th century, and still the biggest secret. It will challenge you, shock you, horrify you, and hopefully motivate you to redouble your efforts to humble yourself and seek strength from God Almighty. The programming procedures, which are described in this book, are based on research and consultation with deprogrammers, ex-programmers, therapists, counselors, and pertinent literature. To the best of our knowledge, the statements made in this book are factual, although they may not reflect the latest or currently accepted methodology among each and every faction of the New World Order, which carries out monarch-type programming. This book tends to devote more emphasis to Illuminati programming, which is the highest level of programming. For individual application in understanding a survivor of monarch programming, therapists are admonished to use this material with consideration for the monarch victim's personal case and situation. The authors disclaim any responsibility for therapeutic work based upon this material. Fritz Springmeier and Cisco Wheeler have co-authored They Know Not What They Do, an illustrated guide to monarch programming mind control. Both Fritz and Cisco bring years of experience in dealing with monarch programming to bear on the writing of this book. Fritz has researched the Illuminati, while he has worked with victims of its programming. He has authored the top 13 Illuminati families, and several other books. Table of contents for podcasts 1 through 10, about the first half of this book. Chapter 1: The Selection and Preparation of the Victim. A. Genetics and Dissociative Abilities. B. Availability. C. Physical and mental requirements. D. List of organizations carrying out programming. E. 4 foundational steps for programming. F. Step 1. Spiritual requirements, moonchild ceremonies, traumatization in vitro. G. Step 2. Trauma by premature birth. H. Step 3. Love bombing / love bonding. I. Step 4. Severing the core of the mind. J. Further considerations. Chapter 2: The traumatization and torture of the victim. A. A site for torture of children, Knott's China Lake. B. What trauma does, the creation of post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, dissociative identity disorder, DID, and multiple personality disorder, MPD. See how the torture is carried out, types of trauma. D. How MPD works. E. The core. F. The anchoring experience. Chapter 3. The use of drugs. A. A list of drugs used. B. A brief history of use. C. Applications for drugs to control a slave. Chapter 4. A. The use of hypnosis. A. Dissociation, trance, and its historical use. B. How to program with hypnosis. C. How to boost creativity of victim with hypnosis. D. Keeping the mind dissociative. E. Keeping the mind in a programming state. F. Hypnotic triggers and cues. G. Hypnosis in programs and other uses. Chapter 4. B. Hypnosis continued. Chapter 5. A. The skill of lying, the art of deceit. A. Overview. B. The use of fiction. C. The use of lies externally, including covers and fronts. D. The use of internal deceptions, including the art of hiding things in a system. Chapter 5. B. The skill of lying, the art of deceit, Billy Graham. Chapter 1. The selection and preparation of the victim. A. Selection based on genetics and dissociative abilities. B. Availability. C. Mental and physical features. One of the primary reasons that the monarch mind control programming was named monarch programming was because of the monarch butterfly. The monarch butterfly learns where it was born, its roots, and it passes this knowledge via genetics onto its offspring, from generation to generation. This was one of the key animals that tipped scientists off that knowledge can be passed genetically. The monarch program is based upon Illuminati and Nazi goals to create a master race in part through genetics. If knowledge can be passed genetically, then it is important that parents be found that can pass the correct knowledge onto those victims selected for the monarch mind control. The primary important factor for the trauma-based mind control is the ability to disassociate. It was discovered that this ability is passed genetically from generation to generation. American Indian tribes, who had traumatic ritual dances and who would wait motionless for hours when hunting, children of fakirs in India, who would sleep on a bed of nails or walk on hot coals, children of yogis, those skilled in yoga, who would have total control over their body in trance, Tibetan Buddhists, children of Vodoun, Bizango and other groups have a good ability to disassociate. The children of multigenerational abuse are also good at dissociation. The Illuminati families and European occultists went to India and Tibet to study occultism and Eastern philosophy. These Europeans learned yoga, tantric yoga, meditations, trances, and other methods to disassociate. These skills are passed on to their children via genetics. A test is run when the children are about 18 months old to determine if they can dissociate enough to be selected for programming or not. Mind-controlled slaves are created for different purposes, hierarchy or non-hierarchy purposes. The Illuminati create mind-controlled slaves who are to function within the Illuminati hierarchy. These slaves will usually have their genealogies hidden, and will be created to have excellent cover lives to ensure that they are not detected. They will be given multifunctional programming, and will usually be used to help program other slaves. The abuse will not be as physically visible as it will be on the bodies of slaves who are not born to be part of the Illuminati elite. Members of Mariah's, Mariah equals the Illuminati, Luciferian elite will have undergone as much trauma as other slaves, however the torture scars and the control are better concealed. These children will often receive lavish experiences as well as talks to convince them that they are part of the elite. By the way, body scars will show up better under black light, that is the same black light as used in clubs. The Illuminati and other organizations have also programmed individuals who are simply expendable. These are sex slaves who are used up and killed very early in life, one-time use as saboteurs, breeders, soldiers, drug couriers, and so forth. The bodies of these people will often show visible torture scars. The expendable are the children of parents who were blackmailed into turning their children over to the CIA. This is all hidden by the power of the National Security Act. These are children who have been sold by pedophile fathers or pornographic parents. The programmers and masters program them with the expectation that they will be thrown from the freedom train when they get to age 30. Freedom train is the code word for the monarch trauma-based mind control. To be thrown from the freedom train means to be killed. The CIA and the Illuminati are skilled at blackmailing parents to give up their children. They would watch the mail for porn. Pedophile and murderers who abuse their children are warned that they will go to prison for long lengths of time if they do not cooperate by selling their children into mind-controlled slavery. In return for the parents' cooperation, they provide rich financial rewards to the parent or parents. It's clearly a case of if you don't cooperate, you lose in life big time, if you do cooperate, you win big time. Religious ministers are often set up with betas, a sexual model of slave, who then blackmails them. The ministers do not want to lose their status and profession via scandals, so they agree to turn their children over when young to the CIA to work with. The Illuminati like to blackmail these ministers when they are finished with their seminary schooling and committed to the ministry at about 33 years of age. The idea of having nothing to fall back on after they have committed their entire life to one profession is too much for these weak-willed men, and they buckle under the threats. If they don't buckle under, the resulting consequences will remove them from ministry. The type of father who is most preferred by the programmers to offer up their children for programming is the pedophile. If a father will abuse his own little baby girl, then the programmers know that the man has no conscience. This father's involvement in criminal activity, and thereby his vulnerability, can be continually increased. They want men who they believe will not develop any qualms later on in life about what they have done. A man, who waits until his daughter is a teenager to molest her, is usually esteemed to have too much conscience for the programmers. A big distinction must be made between hierarchy monarch slaves, and non-hierarchy monarch slaves. The reason there is such a big distinction is that they are not programmed the same way. Since this book is giving the recipe for how to create a monarch slave, we will have to cover the distinction between slaves within the Illuminati and those slaves who function outside of the Illuminati hierarchy. It is important to stress that the label monarch is used in this book in a generic sense for the modern trauma-based total mind control that is taking place. Whether an Illuminati mind-controlled slave is technically in the monarch records or out of the actual monarch program data files kept on computer is merely a technicality. In my, Fritz's, other writings, I explain about how the Illuminati created the CIA. I know that some of its directors were members of the Illuminati, and I strongly suspect that the other CIA directors were probably full-fledged members too. The two organizations need each other. If the CIA didn't have the international backing of the movers and shakers of the world, it would have been exposed and done away with. Likewise, the Illuminati, because it is so secret, needs organizations through which it can work. The CIA is a front for the Illuminati, and the CIA in turn sets up fronts. Some of those fronts are elaborate, well-staffed, well-equipped programming sites, such as many of the state mental hospitals, McGill Psychiatric Training Network consisting of 8 Montreal hospitals, especially St. Mary's, NASA in Huntsville AL, the Presidio, San Francisco, CA, and Knott's at China Lake, CA, to name a few. For a more complete list, see Appendix B. The Illuminati couldn't do it alone without its fronts. Satanists within the network and the CIA took over Boys Town, Nebraska, exposed in the Conspiracy of Silence video in the early 1950s, and used that famous orphanage for a constant supply of boys for programming. Boys Town is perhaps the most famous, but there is a long list of others. Joseph Mengele. When the monarch programming started, the top men were Illuminati. Originally, Joseph Mengele was the lead programmer. He had already achieved the rank of Grand Master, later Ipsimus, within the Illuminati. He had become skilled in music, in Kabbalistic magic, in dancing, in abortions, and in torture. By the way, Mengele had a sadistic mother, and programming children. Many of the concentration camp children that Mengele programmed still survive and still love him to this day as daddy. Mengele disappeared from Auschwitz in January 1945, several months before the final chaos began in the Third Reich. Menschel disappeared so the Illuminati could smuggle him to the US, so that his exceptional knowledge of programming honed and fine-tuned on thousands of concentration camp child victims could be put to use on a grande scale in the United States. He traveled worldwide, but especially in the western US doing his programming accompanied by his pair of two black servants. American monarch survivors remember his spotless German uniform, his shiny boots, which he wore during programming, his thick German accent, his handsome features, his cleft chin, the space in his front teeth, the way he would jab with his thumb while programming, as if he were still saying links, wrecks to lines of Jews coming into the concentration camps. The reason Menschel was so excited to do the selection process of inmates coming into Auschwitz was that he was choosing inmates for his numerous mind control trauma experiments. He was especially anxious to get identical twins, because his genetic research related to mind control needed persons of identical genetic makeup. Traditionally, the Illuminati had been having their children inspected by a woman with the rank of Grande Mother. She would determine the fitness of the children and then present them for a formal acceptance ceremony at age 3 to the Grande Druid Council. This procedure didn't change when Menschel came over. The programming just jumped from being an occult science to one that had full access to the medical, psychiatric, judicial, scientific and governmental sectors via the power of the National Security Act and the intelligence agencies. The Illuminati's programming of multiples prior to Menschel's arrival were simplistic, compared to the sophisticated techniques engineered by the Nazi Germans, whose mind control research included some non-German nationals such as Italians. A victim who is killed by an 18th century musket is just as dead as someone killed by an M16, so a victim of the pre-1946 programming was just as victimized as those programmed with more sophisticated techniques. For the Illuminati, the child's programming is planned by the Circle, another name for their organization, before it is born. From the Illuminati's perspective, their plans involve generational spirits and positions within the hierarchy. The child is conceived according to their rituals, and the steps that that child will go through follows a well-thought-out detailed regimen for programming it. In contrast, the children from foster homes, or pedophiles do not receive the same regimen. Hierarchy slaves will in turn be used to program and train other hierarchy children, while CIA slaves, mafia slaves, and KKK slaves etc. will be discarded. This is why a presidential model is thrown from the Freedom Train. Freedom Train is the name given to the monarch program in the underworld. Women and men in the Illuminati will continue to help with the programming for their entire lives. The Illuminati is programming such vast numbers of children, they need every one of their able members to help. Mariah's total membership, which worldwide numbers in the millions. The Illuminati regimen for their children is far more controlling than the CIA's programming. Not everyone in the Illuminati gets their mind split and becomes a programmed multiple. However, everyone does get some type of mind control. Those who have been spared multiplicity still must participate in a two-week intense mind control session that might be compared to the Army's Ranger School. Those who participate in this have learned obedience. Those who haven't learned obedience are forced into ritual gladiator-type duels or other punishments to eliminate them. Finally, a traitor's death as pictured on one of the tarot cards is waiting. Sharon Tate was left hanging in the number 12 tarot cards hangman position from the house rafters. The best therapists will quietly admit that traditional therapy is inadequate. Unless God intervenes, people who are born into the Illuminati don't escape it while alive. This book isn't a mere exercise of academic thinking, but is written with the assurance that freedom is possible. There are viable answers. Some children live in foster homes, or with adopted parents, or in orphanages, or with caretakers and guardians. Because these children are at the mercy of the non-related adults, these types of children frequently are sold to become mind-controlled slaves of the intelligence agencies. In review, remember that because many of these organizations are controlled by the Illuminati, an Illuminati slave may often work for one of these front groups, while the Illuminati maintain control over the base program. The intelligence networks were started by and are controlled by the Illuminati. They are Illuminati fronts. The use of slaves crosses many organizational boundaries within the overall network. If a slave is to be used as a Delta model, assassination, they may be selected for strength and dexterity. The Delta Force is the U.S. Army's elite unit made up of monarch slaves. If they are to operate as a Beta model, sexual slave, they will be chosen if they can master technique. Occasionally they might in some circumstances be selected for how pretty the programmers expect the child to become. Some parents have produced good-looking children and are actually sought after to bear children to sell into the mind-controlled slavery freedom train system. However, vastly more important for beta sex slaves are their ability to be programmed to have charm, seductive skills, charisma, and creativity. Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and the programmers can put almost any kind of body to use as a sex slave. Almost any sex slave can fit somewhere into the script of the Illuminati / New World Order / Crime Syndicate porn movies. I place porn in quotation marks because what they call porn doesn't resemble what the public thinks of porn. We're not talking Playboy type porn, we're talking ghastly horrible atrocities that are as sick as anything done in the Nazi concentration camps. For instance, it takes little acting ability or beauty to have one's head chopped off while having sex. There are different types of sexual slaves, but the Illuminati wants to get beta alters which are sharp, talented, skilled, and resourceful. They will use these beta alters, such as the Black Widow alters, for espionage and blackmail. To make sure that the child's mind develops properly, the baby will be interacted with so that those areas of the brain that are important to develop will develop to the maximum. It is a well-known fact that areas of the brain grow according to how much stimulation and use that area of the brain receives. For this reason, grande dames, who are involved in programming, will spend time drawing and showing faces to the child and seeing if the child can recognize identical faces. Almost any other item will be used, candy canes with stripes, match the candy canes with the same no of stripes, trees, or pencils. The child must learn to match identical items very early even before they can speak. This is so they will be able to build mirror images into their mind. All the senses are trained for building the mirror images, for instance such as silks and cottons can be used for the sense of touch. The child will have to match textures. The programmer, the grande dame, and grande mothers will teach the child to have good abilities in copying, reflecting, repeating, echoing, or re-echoing, and mirroring. They will be taught for hours how to re-echo something verbatim. Some of these teaching methods are almost like games. For instance, 20 pins will be in a box and the small child is given a short time to decide how many pins are in the box. A certain level of intelligence and creativity is needed for time to be invested on programming. You cannot program a mind which is weak. Most of the people programmed are very intelligent. One study of multiples said that multiples were 130 or above in IQ and then mistakenly blamed their multiplicity on their IQ. Attempts to program people with low intelligence or no creativity were discovered to be a waste of time. Methods are used to greatly enhance the victim's intelligence and creativity. The Illuminati will also work on enhancing their psychic abilities such as telepathy and clairvoyance. The head programmers have their own little mottos about building solid structures which they like to express to new trainees. These include: an unstructured house mind of the slave is like unto a house without walls, a house undisciplined is like unto a house without walls, it will crumble within itself, and a house divided against itself will not stand. Much of the structuring will be discussed in Chapter 7, but the structuring begins at birth for the victim, so this chapter will discuss the first steps. In order to build a solid good house, one needs to have a solid foundation. In order to build a solid foundation, one needs to know how the land lays and what the weaknesses of the land are, if it is sand or rock or clay, etc. One needs to design one's house to take advantage of the natural lay of the land. Will storms come from this or that direction? Where will the house need extra protection? The very same principles pertain to programming because a structure is being built. Many evil geniuses within the Illuminati added their contributions to the monarch programming. John Gittinger and P.A.S. One of the most important was John Gittinger of Oklahoma, because he was the genius who could understand how a little child's mind was when it was in infancy. In order to work with something, you must know what you are working with. John Gittinger, who is no longer alive, worked at programming for years. His contribution was in the mental assessment area. John Gittinger, born 1909, was the director of psychological services at the State Hospital in Norman, Oklahoma. He got a master's degree at age 30, and joined the CIA's MK-Ultra Mind Control in 1950. He was a high school guidance counselor and a Navy lieutenant commander during WW2. In the late 1970s, he moved back to Oklahoma. He was heavy-set and goateed. It's been said he looked like the actor Walter Slezak. He had an insatiable curiosity about understanding human personality. When the Illuminati looked around for men skilled in personality assessment to assist the monarch programming, John W. Gittinger was one of their men who they selected. Gittinger was not the only researcher into personality that the CIA hired, but he was their top man in terms of the programming of children. From the end of WW2 until he began with the CIA in 1950, Gittinger was studying how to assess personality. At the Oklahoma State Hospital, he had large numbers of adults who could be studied. After Gittinger started doing personality assessment for the CIA, most of his work became highly classified. The Rolling Stone article of July 18, 1974 asked why years of research into personality assessment should be so secret. In fact, it was so secret, Gittinger was not allowed to talk to journalists, even though it was public knowledge that Gittinger did personality assessment work and research. The reason that such an apparently benign science was kept secret is that it plays a major part in the success of the monarch programming. John Gittinger designed the personality assessment system, PAS. This is an extraordinary method to evaluate human behavior and predict their future behavior. As far as we know, most of the PA is still classified secret. The PA is based on the ability to differentiate different types of people. There are three major dimensions, or differentiations. They are called the EI dimension, the RF dimension, and the AU dimension. People are born with their original placement within each of these three spectrums. In other words, there are three axes that can be graphed to describe a baby's personality. The baby might be graphed I, internalizer, F, flexible, and A, role adaptive. If the baby were graphed this way, i.e., IFA, then the programmers would automatically know this child's mind will become a social or religious reformer. The child's programming charts would then be labeled some suitable occupation such as environmental activist, Pentecostal church reformer, consumer advocate, or activist against narcotics. The programming for that child then would follow six-month goals to develop that mind-controlled slave into one of the best in that occupation. In fact, one of the co-authors of this book, Fritz, is indeed IFA, which helps explain why he is trying to reform society and religion with this book. While it took Fritz many years to find his correct niche in life, programmed multiples are steered in the correct direction very early in life with all the breaks and all the money needed from the network to open opportunities. There are three possibilities for the child in regards to his original personality components. He can, 1, express the component, or, 2, suppress or, 3, repress it. As the child goes through life, he has two periods within which he can change, suppress or repress, his behavior slash personality. In the PA, the first period is called compensation and the second is called modification. The amount of punishment for a personality trait and pressure to change from others will determine the amount of change which the child's mind will perform on its original personality. The activity level of a person at each point in their life is also measured. The intensity of each of the scores is also rated. The actual PA system is far more detailed than the example above, but it serves to give a simplified idea of how it works. The essential dynamics of an entire personality can be written in a short code which might be written for example 12, EUCFCU plus A plus U plus U, H plus. However, even that code is shortened EUC can be written simply I. The basic three dimensions to personality provide eight basic types. However, the PA allows for six basic positions in each of these eight basic types which yields 216 discrete basic types. Next, the person can change their predisposed primitive personality initially five different ways and this then gives, 30, cubed Oregon, 27000 different types. The second change can be done on four types of modification which makes for 1,728,000 types. Then the programmers can factor in activity level, their normal level, intelligence base, age, sex, and education, and life experiences. In other words, what appears to be simple has a high degree of calibration to it. The person who was best with the PA was its brainchild Gittinger himself. His intuition along with his PA system, gave him an uncanny idea of how a person's S-mind works now, and how it would work in the future. He sadistically reveled in putting his skill to use programming children. The actual assessment codes that have appeared on programming assessment charts which the Monarch Child Assessment Teams have used to evaluate, describe, and assess a child to be programmed, follow the standard symbols created for PA. Some portions of Gittinger's work has escaped the secrecy of the intelligence agencies, concerning the Gittinger Personality Assessment System. See an introduction to the Personality Assessment System by John Wynn and John Gittinger, Journal of Community Psychology Monograph Supplement No. 38. Rutland, Vermont, Clinical Psychology Publishing Co., Inc. 1973. See also the Rolling Stone magazine article, July 18, 1974, The CIA Won't Go Public. Wexler Intelligence Test. Because so little is known about the PA test, it needs to be explained some. Observations in relation to the Wexler intelligence test provided the initial ideas behind the PA. The digit span subtest of the Wexler intelligence test, which rates the ability to remember numbers, forms the basic test used for the EI dimension. What Gittinger discovered was that short order cooks had good number memory, which equals internalizer personality or I. A high digit span in any person tells much about them. People who don't separate themselves well from their environment are externalizers equals E. The I personality was a good baby. The E type, who prefers doing to thinking, is a too curious baby, who will make demands. I's would often be pressured to become more outgoing, and E's are often pressured by parents to be more self-sufficient, and to progress from crawling, which they like, to learn to walk. Pure internalizers become more withdrawn after several drinks, and uncompensated E's are more likely to become sloppy drunks, garrulous. Based on the EI dimension, predictions can also be made for how LSD will affect a person. This is the EI dimension. The block design subtest shows whether a person is a regulated, R, or a flexible, F, person. This is the RF dimension. The regulated person had no trouble learning by rote, but didn't understand what he learned. The flexible person on the other hand had to understand something before he learned it. Our children could learn to play the piano easily, but the great concert piano players were F children who had persevered to master what they considered drudgery. The third dimension is the AU dimension, the role adaptive, A, or a role uniform, U, person. The A could be defined as charisma, while people tend to ignore the U. The CIA has 40 patterns that a skilled observer looks for, and these then are related to the PA and Wexler subtests. Use of the electroencephalogram to shape programming. Illuminati mothers of darkness alters trained in observation, chart what they see a child do. A child's behavior with certain toys, certain hand responses, and certain social responses can be observed and used to assess how this child would score on the PA test. E.g., electroencephalogram, patterns correlate to the PA digit span test. This allowed them to use the EEG patterns to overcome cultural bias in the test. It also gave the monarch programmers the perfect tool to assess small children before they have verbal skills. David R. Saunders, at the University of Colorado working with the CIA, wrote a paper in 1961 showing the connection between alpha waves and digit span. In 1960, Mundy Castle wrote about the connections between EEG printouts and Wechsler Bellevue test variables. Here is the tip of the iceberg that EEGs were being used to determine pre-verbal personality in children. Salvatore, and others, wrote at the Massachusetts Mental Health Center, Boston, Mass., clear back in 1954 about the predictive potential of Gittinger's theory in an unpublished research paper. The Massachusetts Mental Health Center was an early participant in this research. The child's guardians must teach the small victim obedience. They must teach the child to keep its eyes open and to hold still. These skills are important, because the child will be subjected to extensive EEGs. The hospital equipment would be something like an 11-channel grass EEG machine where 11 electrodes are placed on the child's head, and brain wave patterns are printed out charting such things as background, variability, discharges, background suppress ions, sharp waves, etc. The electrodes will have designations such as T3, T4, etc. In special programming sites, a machine with electrodes will be hooked up to the child's head for repeated tests. The newer machines accommodate up to 31/2 diameter pads, electrodes, which are attached with electrode adhesive tape or small needled ends to the child's scalp. The child's hair will be parted in an area, and the electrodes will be hooked to the skull. The attendant will tell the child, "Don't move. Keep your eyes open. Look at this point. Don't blink. Don't move your body." The procedure will be repeated for 45 minutes to an hour. Eventually, hundreds of readout from electrodes clipped to the skull of the child will chart the brain waves of the child. From these brain waves, the programmers can determine what type of personality the child has. This personality assessment criteria and ability is one of the guarded secrets of the programming. Should unexpected behavior crop up, the slave may be hauled in for more EEGs. The PA tests would reveal to Gittinger a person's weaknesses. The PA shows what a person wants. And these are called the soft spots of a person's personality. Also, the PA shows mental weaknesses, or where a person will be INSTable and could be broken down. Certain types of stresses will have a cumulative effect of hurting a person. A stress-producing campaign is run against CIA targets, and by doing this they can neutralize a potential enemy. The information collected from children, who are potential victims for the monarch programming, is essential for knowing how to structure that child's programming. For instance, IFU children often are autistic, IRU are schizophrenic children, and IR or IF are fantasy prone. Later, it will be further explained how this aids programming. An internalizer personality would be important deep inside an alter system, while an externalizer would be useful for a front personality. Internalizers are predisposed to the production of mental fantasy. By knowing what the child was, the programmers know what they already have, and what they must add or build into the thinking of the alters they will create. Likewise, some alters need to be R and some F. And some need to be A and some U regulated, R, personalities like to have narrow limitations on their activity. This makes them suitable for programming. The R's readily accept authority, and will not try to step out of the range of their habits. The R has a marked ability to learn without understanding. They easily learn material by rote, because they do not need to understand it before they will learn it. This is another asset that the programmers like. The programmers may or may not want an A, role adaptive personality. A future country singer needs charisma, a future computer programmer doesn't. Without being able to finally determine what is there, the programming could not be fine-tuned. If the child is good in math, it will have its programming script steered in that direction. M.C. Escher's artwork. If the child has artistic brainwaves, then the programmer will use artwork in programming. The artwork of the European artist M.C. Escher is exceptionally well suited for programming purposes. For instance, in his 1947 drawing Another World, the rear plane in the center serves as a wall in relation to the horizon, a floor in connection with the view through the top opening and a ceiling in regards to the view up towards the starry sky. Reversals, mirror images, illusion, and many other qualities appear in Escher's artwork, which make all 76 or more of his major works excellent for programming. The use of these kinds of elements will explain later. Five children each given the same Alice in Wonderland script will each use the script differently during programming. The programmer takes the child's own creativity and works with that unique creativity. The child must create the images himself if the programming is to hold. It won't work if the images are someone else's. The child organizes its internal world to suit his/her own experiences, such as castles, boxes, rooms, and dollhouses. The PAS type testing will continue during the early years of the slave's life to make sure the programming has not driven the child crazy or psycho. The child will move down the script decided for it for its whole life, based on these early tests. More about how this works later. The EEG tests run frequently on children to be programmed also show brain tumors, and medical problems beside just the brainwave patterns. The PA tests can also show how easy a person can be hypnotized. If the testing by the EEGs doesn't reveal a child who can be easily hypnotized, they will be rejected for programming, even though modern drugs and extreme torture in some cases will be applied to salvage children they really think they need to program, but are clearly not easily hypnotizable. EEGs can also be used to see what state of consciousness the brain is in. The Monarch programming is based on structuring multiple personality disorder, MPD, alter systems, which is covered in Chapter 7. The success of this structuring, its extraordinary fine-tuning, comes from the initial testing, which means programs are properly built on whatever foundation the mind has. The CIA front organization, the Human Ecology Society, tested the PA. In 1962, the CIA moved Gittinger's base of operations to another CIA front on Connecticut Ave, Washington, D.C. called Psychological Assessment Associates. Because Gittinger believed genetic-based differences exist in people, which is one of the basis for the Monarch programming, his work was not accepted by mainstream psychology. In 1974, Gittinger described the PA system. The Personality Assessment System, PAS, A, indicates the kinds of internal and external cues to which the individual is most likely to respond, B, suggests the types of stimuli that are most likely to produce behavioral change, C, provides an understanding of the inter-intra- and impersonal environments in which a person is most likely to function efficiently, and D, offers insight into what constitutes stress and predicts probable behavioral response to such stress, including maladjustments, should they occur. In the area of experience, the PAS offers a method for obtaining specific clues to personality structure and functioning. Thus, the PAS, A, allows for direct inferences concerning an individual's primary response style, B, suggests the quality of the compensations and modifications he has achieved in response to social and environmental pressures, C, provides an understanding of personality development in terms of the interaction of primary structure, environmental pressures, and adaptive tendencies, D, offers a procedure for evaluating the surface or contact personality developed over time, and E, makes possible the assessment of the fundamental discrepancies between the surface personality and the underlying personality structure discrepancies that typically produce tension, conflict, and anxiety. Wynn, John F., and John W. Gittinger. Journal of Community Psychology Monograph Supplement No. 38. Rutland, Vermont, Clinical Psychology Publishing Co., Inc. 1973, p. 99. Wow! Gittinger's description of PAS is specifically the needs and goals that the programmers had when they initiate programming the personality splits in tiny 18-month-old children. People associated with the following listed organizations may assist the network to use their child for trauma-based programming. Children from families where one or both parents belong to the following organizations are often routinely sent off in early childhood for trauma-based mind control. We are now in third and fourth generations of people who are programmed multiples. And even into deeper generations in some Illuminati bloodlines. What can't be covered here is the enormous secret drama involved in Mariah implementing control over parents via prescribed or illegal drugs, fear, blackmail, etc., so that they will assist them in getting the children programmed. If the motherly instinct is too strong, the mom may be prescribed tranquilizers, so that there is a stable house for the child's front altars to grow up in. Unreliable non-multiple fathers are debriefed by Illuminati multiples who debrief and then erase their memories of what is happening to their children. Parents may have only a limited view. Organizations practicing trauma-based mind control. These groups form what insiders call the network. They are the backbone of what is known as the New World Order. 1. Air Force Intelligence. 2. Army Intelligence, such as CIC. 3. The Atomic Energy Commission, AEC. 4. Boeing. 5. British Intelligence, IN. MI6, MI5, and the Tavistock Institute. 6. The Bureau of Narcotics. 7. The Bureau of Prisons. 8. The Roman Catholic Church, including the Jesuit Order. 9. The Central Intelligence Agency, CIA, aka Agency, Company, Langley. 10. The Charismatic Movement. 11. The Church of Satan. 12. The Church of Scientology. 13. Service. 14. Club 12 and Club 41. 15. The Country Music Industry. 16. The Defense Intelligence Agency, DIA. 17. The Department of Justice, DOJ. 18. Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI. 19. Freemasonry, especially the Palladium Rite, 33 degree and above degrees, Quechu or Coronati Lodge, SRIA, and other Masonic-affiliated organizations. 20. Japan. 21. German Intelligence, Shebeck. 22. GHG. 23. Hollywood. 24. The House of Saud in Saudi Arabia, which has unprogrammed slaves too. 25. The Illuminati, also known as the Circle, Mariah, Mariah Conquering Wind, Gnostics, Luciferians, etc., at all levels is involved in trauma-based mind control as perpetrators and victims. Inclining Frat. Saturni Orden Fraternita Saturni, THFS, Fogo, Golden Dawn, Antic, Lucif, Dine, etc. 26. Internal Revenue Service, INS. 27. The Ku Klux Klan, and different KKK groups. 28. The Mafia. 29. The Masons, see Freemasonry. 30. Modi'in. 31. The Mossad, Mossad El-Aliyabeth. 32. The Mormon Church. 33. NASA, National Aeronautics and Space Admin. 34. The National Security Agency, NSA. 35. The National Programs Office. 36. The National Science Foundation, NSF. 37. Naval Intelligence, ONI, Office of Naval Intelligence. 38. Neo-Nazi Groups. 39. The Odd Fellows. 40. Ordo Templi Orientalis, OTO, there are four groups. 41. P.4, Elite MI6 Section. 42. Palo Mayombe. 43. The Process Church and its offshoots, Ching'un etc. 44. Professional Baseball, such as the LA Dodgers. 45. Russian Government and Intelligence Groups, GRU and KGB and the KGB successor, historically an early group known as Spitzbureau No. 1 called Chimera in Russian, which means Chamber did drug and hypnosis mind control research. The Spitzbureau was responsible for assassinations. 46. Santaria. 47. Satanic Hubs, Society of Duke Lily, Children of Lucifer, UK. 48. The Temple of Power, previously known as Temple of Set. 49. Umbanda. 50. The U.S. Army, especially the Delta Forces and the 1st Earth Battalion. 51. The United States Air Force, USAF. 52. The Veterans Administration. 53. The Werewolf Order. 54. Some witchcraft groups besides Satanism and Mariah.